Hello. Today we are going to continue about the complement system. So this is the second video and today we will be learning about alternative pathway and lectin pathway. I had already uploaded first video which covers the introduction on complement system and classical pathway. Okay, you can check it out. So regarding alternative pathway, as I said, it is initiated by or it is triggered by antigens only or endotoxins. Okay, it is antibody independent pathway. Okay, in case of classical pathway, the complex of antigen and antibody that initiated or it activates the classical pathway, but in alternative pathway antibodies play no role. Okay, so many unrelated cell surface substances, for example bacterial lipopolysaccharides which are endotoxins, then fungal cell walls, viral envelopes, they can initiate the process by binding the C3 and factor B. Okay, so in this pathway you will find a factor B. Okay, we will talk about that, talk about the function also. Okay, so let's see the pathway. So here you will find no role of C1 protein, C4 and C2. Okay, directly we are starting from the C3 protein. Okay, so C3 on hydrolysis and the involvement of the factor B and factor D, we get a complex, that is C3H2 B and small b star, that this is the activated form of C3. This acts as C3 convertase. This converts C3 into C3A and C3B. Okay, so we had skipped the first three components. We have here, we these components, they have no role, right? So from C3 we had started. So this complex will convert the C3 completely into C3A and C3B. Okay, so as I said earlier, A subunit is released and C3B, the B subunit, it gets embedded on the cell membrane. Okay, this first structural unit, that is C3B, it recruits more C3. Okay, so this process will happen again and again, more and more C3B is obtained. Okay, C3A is released and C3B is obtained. Again here factor B and factor D are involved, which again acts as C3 convertase. This complex is formed which acts as C3 convertase. Again it converts C3 into C3A and C3B. A is released, B is kept, or we can say it is attached to the bacterial cell membrane. Okay, so once there is a complex, that is C3B, capital B, B star, C3B, it acts as C5 convertase. Okay, this will convert C5 into C5A and C5B. A is released and B is attached to the bacterial cell surface. So same as classical pathway, the C6, C7, C8 and C9 proteins, those are attached. Okay, and a C5B9 MSC, that is membrane attack complex, is formed. Okay, and this is the last step where the pores are formed on the bacterial cell surface and cell gets lysed. Okay, so this is about the alternative pathway. Okay, so how these factors are attached. So this is the C3, first C3. To that a factor B is attached, and to both of these the factor D is attached. Okay, so this actually activates the C3. Okay, so this is about the factor B and factor D. C3 and B, actually those are first inactive state. When D comes, it activates B to BA and BB. Okay, so the factor B also, it gets cleaved or break down into BA and BB, right? So that's why here it is written as capital B, small b, star. So it converts, then it converts C3 into C3A and C3B. Okay, so this is the explanation. C3 is very important. It recruits the factor B. Both are inactive. Now factor D attaches. It makes C3 active. And now C3B gets embedded in the cell membrane. Now C3B will recruit more C3 to which B and D attaches and converts the C3 into C3A and C3B by activating the factor B. Here no C4B and C2A complex is there, right? As I said, there is no role of C1, C4 and C2, okay? So C3 convertase is required, and this C3B will bind to cell membrane and is embedded and C3A is released. Okay, so I am talking about this step. Okay, after the first conversion, again this C3B will recruit more C3. This same process will happen. The factor B is also involved here, and it also gets breakdown or cleaved into BB factor, this B subunit, and again we get a complex which is a C3 convertase, right? Then we get one more complex, that is C5 convertase. Okay, so this is explained here. So once C3B is present, it either or high, when it is in high concentration, it either can go for, or it can either call for opsonization by phagocytosis, or can recruit the C5 for the cell lysis. That is, it will recruit C5 for the formation of membrane attack complex, okay, and resulting into the cell lysis. Okay, so this is about the C3B. It is very important component in the complement system. Okay, so now we will see the functions for factor B, factor D and properdin. So there are also active components as B, BA and BB. Okay, so the factor B, it binds to the membrane bound C3B and then it is cleaved by the factor D. The role of subunit A, that is factor BA, is unknown. The role of factor B, small b, is it is cleaved from the stabilized by P produced C3 convertase. So that is nothing but the P stands for the properdin, which has the function of binding and stabilizing the membrane bound C3B B small b factor, which is this. Okay, so it is said as it is cleaved from stabilized P produced by C3 convertase. Okay, then we have factor D, which has an active component as D itself, and the role is it cleaves factor B when bound to the C3B. Okay, so this was about the alternative pathway. Now let's study about the lectin pathway. Okay, so it is also known as MBL pathway, which is mannan binding lectin or mannose binding protein. Okay, MBL is a protein which is synthesized in liver. Okay, so some bacteria, they have the residues of mannose and glucose sugar on their cell wall. Okay, so when they invade our body, or when they invade a host system, these residues are recognized by the MBLs, that is the mannose binding proteins. Okay, so on having infection, the protein MBL recognizes these residues and it activates a protease called MASP. Okay, so this binding, the recognition and binding, will activate a protease which is known as MASP, mannose binding lectin associated serine protease. Okay, so which binds to the MBL and it activates the component C4 and C2. Okay, so MBL and MASP are now attached, or the MASP is activated and it has now attached to the MBL. So it has now activated the C4 and C2. C4 and C2 will get cleaved as C4A, C4B, C2A and C2B. Okay, so here C4B and C2A will combine and they will act as a C3 convertase. C3 convertase will convert C3 into C3A and C3B. C3B will attach to this complex. It will act as C5 convertase. C5 convertase will convert the C5 into C5A and C5B. C5B will again attach to a complex, or it will form a complex with C4B, C2A, C3B. Okay, and now it will call for the membrane attack complex formation. Okay, it will call the other proteins. So this is the in short pathway. Once C4 and C2 are activated, a complex is made which is C3 convertase. This will convert C3, and another complex is made which is C5 convertase. This will convert C5 into C5A and C5B. So B calls C6. When C6 is attached or it is added, it acts as a receptor for C7. When C7 is added, then it acts as a complex. It acts as a acceptor for C8. When C8 is added, whole complex acts as a acceptor for C9. And C9 is the protein which forms the pores on the bacterial cell wall, due to which cell leaks out and it dies. Okay, so this was about the lectin and alternative pathway. I hope this video is helpful to you all. Do share these videos with your friends and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.